Northwestern defensive back Brandon Joseph has announced that he is transferring to Notre Dame. First off, massive, massive pickup. I mean, everything has been coming up spades for, for Marcus Freeman at Notre Dame since he took over the job, albeit, you know, the Fiesta Bowl aside, right? Like, let's mark that one out, but the recruiting has picked up. Transfers are coming in. He's got guys staying on board. He hired the offensive line coach that basically built OLU at Notre Dame. This is all coming up roses, man. This is a really, I think, a good decision for Brandon Joseph. Don't get me wrong. Pat Fitzgerald, fantastic coach. But you also know, much like we just talked about at Ames, Iowa, there is a ceiling there, right? Every now and then, you can have an outstanding year, but you are just as likely to fall back into the cellar as you are to be the winner of the Big Ten West. And I don't know that you've got the ability to actually win the Big Ten Conference at Northwestern right now. For Brandon Joseph, I think it's a smart move.
No. Anybody who says is not a smart move is a fool, okay? It's 100% the right move for him. It's a great move for him. It's a great move for Notre Dame. If I was a defensive player for Northwestern, I would be having some difficulties because this offense has been in the Stone Age for, you know, at least the last decade, a very long time. And when they win, it's because the defense plays with Herculean effort and pulls off some miraculous shit. And I would be frustrated with that. I would now have an opportunity to go play for a better team all around the board and a team that I know that I don't have to hold people to 20.
And you don't have to move that far. Notre Dame and Northwestern are not far away.
You're staying in the private school world. You know, the way things are done at Notre Dame aren't a whole lot different than the way things are done at you know, it's not like you're moving from UCF to Notre Dame, right? Where you used to party in Orlando every night of your life and kind of able to get away with whatever the hell you want. And now you're going and living in a dorm at Notre Dame. And like you got nuns and brothers, you know, whipping you with rulers, kind of keeping you in line. this is not anything that he's, you know, outside of, you know, Northwestern is a very, very small, private, very well respected school. I love Pat. I think Pat is a great coach. He is terrified to hand the reins to the offense to somebody young and innovative. We thought when he hired Bajakian that he was going to do that because Bajakian ran a very spread, kind of high powered, you know,
still rushing, but spread offense.
And he brought a guy in that ran that style of offense and said, nope, you're going to run power. You're going to run I formation. We're going to run it with big, fat, slow running backs instead of super athletic running backs. And, you know, this is you're never going to have a great quarterback because we're just not going to value that position enough in recruiting. And that's been a struggle. That's been a problem. But we've had this conversation before, right?
Yeah.
Like there's been multiple times where I see defenses play so outside of the norm of how good they can be. And offenses just give the ball away. And I tell you all the time, this is why I would be a terrible player. This is why I wouldn't work very well. Is because I would have a hard time going into halftime and not kicking the shit out of somebody. Okay? I'm going to walk to the other side of the field, and I'm going to start slapping folks. All right? Because we're doing our job. And at some point in time, yes, we're all a team, but we can't all be a team and win as a team when we're the reason we're winning and you're the reason we're losing. At some point in time, you got to be a part of this damn team too. You got to actually do your job and do it well. And that offense for Northwestern, even the year that they played in the Big Ten title game just 2 years ago and 2 years before that, it doesn't matter. They're still awful offensively.
The offense was
They're wildly predictable, and they're just awful. The defense has been ungodly good. Their offensive line, ungodly good. Doesn't matter. That offense is it. When you become predictable, even bad teams can beat you.
Yes. Yes, you are correct. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter @GaryWCE at Chris B. Giannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.